A lot of people have asked me since I got into the race, you know, why are you running? Why would you want to get involved with this? And very simply, just like most of you, I'm just fed up. As a wife, as a mother, as a former accountant, I am deeply concerned about the state of our state, the corruption, the out-of-control spending, and the arrogance that goes along with it. And I just couldn't keep complaining anymore. We have such a great opportunity to actually affect what type of state our children and grandchildren will inherit. And years from now, when my children ask me, "Mom, what did you do to fight for my freedom?" I'm going to tell them I tried to be the best wife and mother that I could be, and I advocated for you at school board meetings where I fought the political indoctrination, the dumbed down curriculum, the financial mismanagement, but I didn't stop there. I'm going to tell them about running for Republican precinct committeeman and winning my election because I wanted to be a voice for them and an example, but I didn't stop there. I'm going to tell them that when I learned that my Democrat opponent, incumbent State Senator Arthur J. Wilhelmy, voted for the 67% tax increase, the largest in our state's history, which would have decreased their future opportunities and decreased their standard of living, I decided to take him on and take on the Chicago machine. So this is about my kids. I'm fighting for my kids and future generations, and I hope that you all are doing the same. That's what this is all about to me. There are so many Americans that have fought for our freedoms, like the men who walked into certain death on D-Day into a hail of bullets. They've done their part, and now it's time for us to do our part. And as I go around and I talk to people door to door, they just want common sense solutions to our state's problems. And I have kind of the opposite situation that John was describing. A lot of people assume I'm a Democrat, which kind of helps, because my district is 2-to-1 Democrat district. So after I've had that minute or two to go through my talking points with them and go through my platform, I might get a question sometimes, well, are you Republican or Democrat? I say, I'm a conservative and I'm running as a Republican. And I've gotten a lot of yard signs from Democrats because they heard the message. It's a message of common sense. This is not an election about labels. It's not an election about parties. It's common sense. And I met a mom out walking one day. She was busy taking groceries from the van into the house, and her kids were helping her, and I didn't have a lot of time. I introduced myself, I gave her my walk card. She agreed with me that Springfield needed more accountants. And so she went inside, and I went on walking. Later on that night, I got an email, and in the subject line it said, "Grocery Mom." And she said, "You know, we had a brief encounter earlier this evening, but I sensed your sincerity. And I wish I had had more time to talk to you." She said, "You know, I checked out your website and you have my full support." She said, I'm one of those people who just had lost hope in Illinois and thought it was just a waste to even vote in our state anymore. But just meeting another mom who was concerned about her kid's future, who showed up at my door, got me interested, and she said that she wanted to get involved in local politics for a long time, and now she thought that she might actually do it. She is an example of the thousands and millions of people in our state that have just been completely left behind. And it's going to take people like you and like me who are running for office and getting involved, helping candidates to bring those people in so that they know there is something we can do. And this organization, the Homer Lockport Tea Party, is an example of that. This is true grassroots, and we can affect what type of state our children and grandchildren inherit. You know, last night we had a great event. We had a town hall in Romeoville. We were expecting 20 people. We had over 30 people, standing room only. It was a fantastic event, and we talked about jobs, spending, corruption, and people, and I've seen this as I've gone door to door, people want jobs and economic opportunities in our state. They don't want any more promises, they don't want any more handouts, and they don't care about party labels. One of the things we talked about last night was the Capitol bill. We are literally mortgaging or spending our children and grandchildren's money for pork and waste that is absolutely unconscionable. Even the Chicago Tribune editorial board pointed out over $3 billion in what they call pork in the Capitol bill. Now, just to give you an example, my opponent was on the Tom Rosier show, radio show, about 2 or 3 weeks ago, bragging about, as part of the Capitol bill, how he brought two new schools to the district. Now, mind you, Joliet Township High School is owed $6 million by the state. And this, we see this all across the state of Illinois. Yet he's bragging about spending money that we don't have for two new schools when we can't even pay the bills for the schools that we have now. This is how upside down the priorities are in our legislators in Springfield. This is why I'm running. We have one of the most hostile business environments in the country. Robert Enriquez mentioned it in his talk. When Caterpillar announced that they were opening a new plant, they're going to Texas to create those 500 new jobs. And when Boeing announced that they were going to build their new Dreamliner plant, or their new Dreamliner aircraft, they went to South Carolina, where they're going to be creating up to 12,000 new jobs over 3 years. Illinois wasn't even in the running, because we are hostile to businesses because of our high taxation, high regulations, excessive litigation. It's easy to be sued in Illinois. It's a judicial hellhole. And we have to attack taxation, litigation, and regulation if we're going to create a more favorable environment for businesses in our state. And that's why I need your help. I have two people here tonight that have been volunteering for me. Raquel is my DuPage Township volunteer coordinator, and Craig Campio is my Lockport Township volunteer coordinator. They are absolutely fantastic, and Craig and I walked together, and I think that was your first time walking door to door. Was it last month? I mean, it's just been in the past month or month and a half. We went out, and Craig walked with me that day. We were out for about 4 hours, and Craig learned that quick. He's been walking Lockport for weeks. I mean, he's just absolutely fantastic. This is what it's going to take. Ordinary citizens going out and helping candidates. So if you would like to help, we definitely could use your help. Phone calling, walking. We have a great letter writing program that we're doing. We're utilizing volunteers to hand address envelopes, if that's something that you would like to do. So you can just contact either one of them and we can sign you up. But we can't do this without your help, financial or otherwise. We really have a tremendous opportunity to change this state. And even if we get people in Springfield with conservative principles, and we may still be the minority, it's still a start. November 2nd is just the beginning. We're going to have to continue this, and it's going to take a few election cycles to get there. But we have to start. And that's why I'm glad to see that John is running as a conservative in the Democrat Party. We need more ordinary citizens who aren't lawyers, nothing against lawyers, to run for office, that want to problem solve, that understand common sense and want to implement common sense in Springfield. So take Steve up on his offer. If you want to run for office, he's been in my corner since day one, as well as everyone else in the Homer Lockport Tea Party. So thank you very much.